I'm crying.
Simon's back, literally. An audience without masks, so life is returning to normal. Or is it? Because fan favorite Seth Ward finally makes it onto the show. This first episode of America's Got Talent, Sophia busts a nut. On this week's recap, it was the season 16 premiere of America's Got Talent, and Simon Cowell is back after his electric bike accident.
That's right, and Howie gave up his golden buzzer, and dogs replaced the judges. What do you think of that?
Everything was crazy. It was all moving so fast. And honestly, when I saw dogs sitting at the judging panel, I was just really confused.
Like, what is happening, right?
Yeah.
Even the judges looked like they were confused. I didn't even know it was an act at first. I was like, is this a story? What is this?
I'm so happy that Simon is back and he was showing off his long, luscious legs in a pair of white shorts.
I know, what was the shorts? But he looks good. He looks thin. He looks healthy.
Howie Mandel hit his golden buzzer for Northwell Health Nurse Choir. First of all the frontline workers out there, you guys are amazing.
Yes, and thank you so much.
Yeah, and I'm just so happy that Howie was able to like pay it back for everything that they've done throughout the pandemic.
Yeah, I feel like, you know, they were really great, and I feel like even more important, what they've done is so incredible. So I got emotional just hearing kind of their story and their journey. Mm-hmm. And so I'm so glad they got the golden buzzer. It was worth it.
Speaking of amazing performances, I feel like we gotta talk about our favorite performances of this week. So for me, I think the best performance was Peter Rosalita, because he has some serious pipes. I mean, All By Myself, we hear this song all the time talent shows. And for some reason, this one just really resonated with me, and I loved it so much.
And he was a cutie pie. Just hearing him talk, you know what I mean? He was so cute, the judges loved him. And then when he opened up his mouth and had that voice, that was incredible. My favorite performance was a magician. She saw me, I was here, I was getting really emotional. The story, he adopted a son, I adopted my son, told you that. But just how he weaved that into his act, I could not stop crying. She was laughing at me here.
I was not laughing, you guys. I have a soul. And this audition was actually released before the premiere. And I wrote about Dustin Tavella over on talentrecap.com. And if you go read the story, you can find out how he has a special connection to Selena Gomez.
Really?
Yes.
Well, that's awesome news.
Yes. And I thought his act was so cool. I mean, I like that it was emotional, and I do have a soul, okay? But let's be real here. I feel like the real winner this week, or the one that had one of the most shocking and best performances, was Keith Apicary.
Yeah, you know what? I was going to say too. So Keith came on and it seemed like it was to be a joke. It seemed like he was going to be goofy. And I was laughing and I was having fun. It was my favorite performance of the night. So I know we said that was the best one. That was my favorite. How about you?
Yeah, I've never like smiled so much as I did while I was watching Keith's performance. And just something about him like air humping the floor was just really making me happy. He fell off the stage, I was like, what's going on? But at the end he was like, yeah. And I was like, all right, like this is something I could get behind.
So if you're watching this, Keith, we want to have you on the show.
Yes, totally. Let us know down below, you guys, who were some of your favorite performances this week?
Okay, so now let's talk about the worst performance of the week. What did you think? What did you guys think?
Oh, God. Well, Mr. Cherry.
Yeah, it was kind of random.
Was cracking them nuts.
Cracking them nuts.
Yeah, I think.
These nuts?
These nuts. Got him!
Come on,
okay. Jeremy. These nuts.
Got it.
Okay, it's late and we're getting a little loopy.
Gets flagged. I'm crying. You guys, we can't keep it together because we're just thinking about Mr. Cherry's performance. Yeah. It was insane. This man was cracking walnuts with his butt.
And then what was crazy was Sofia Vergara tried to go up and try to do it herself, and she couldn't do it. Her butt wasn't hard enough.
Is it really hard?
I think you should crack a nut with your butt and try it.
Can I?
Yeah.
Which side is your strong butt?
I don't know. I've never thought about that.
Yeah.
Yes.
You gotta tighten them up.
Yeah.
No! No, it didn't work.
What, did it hurt? Does it hurt?
It really hurts.
Yeah, Sophia thinks she permanently injured her butt. But it's cool that they had, like, a person who breaks so many records on the show.
Yeah,
he definitely broke something, all right.
Yeah, he broke a world record, so that was good, but that was the one of those performances that was like, what is happening?
Yeah, yeah. Now it's time for the WTF moment. You guys, the WTF moment this week has to be Seth Ward.
You know, I just have to say, you know, we have a compilation video of the worst accidents on shows. He's fallen off the stage several times. And I was doing the voiceover and I was like, he's the most annoying contestant that's ever come on America's Got Talent. But he actually made me laugh this time. Mm-hmm. It was fun.
This is all I have, Howie!
You're not a bloody peacock.
My butt fell off, let me have this!
You're just trying to save yourself from the haters. You guys, I know that Seth Ward has a lot of fans out there from all over the world, and I actually think his performance was hilarious.
Yeah, it was great.
But like at the same time, there was so much yelling and chaos and just like laughter.
He was pecking the stage.
Yeah, and like he was like flirting with Sophia in peacock language at some point.
Okay. And then like, what about him getting on top of the rock
yeah. And
trying to fly, and you know he's gonna crash into the stage.
Yeah, like I loved it, but I also was confused.
Yeah, I loved it, and I was kind of like, what the?
What WTF?
Yeah. Another really cool thing is this is the first live studio audience after COVID. What'd you think of that?
I was like confused, because I'm like, is there an audience, is there not an audience? Was there a limited audience and they just like CGI'd it? But I talked to the audience warm-up guy, Chuck, and he said that he hopes they'll bring him back for the live shows with a limited audience. So we'll see what happens.
Just hope nobody coughs.
Yeah. And while we mentioned all of these incredible acts, I feel like we have to also talk about for a second the comedy duo Gerald and Lil Hunter Kelly.
Yeah, Lil Hunter upstaged his dad.
He was sassy. I loved it.
Yeah, he was great. There was one moment where he forgot what he was gonna say, mm-hmm. and it's just this long silence, and I kept thinking, oh God, we're just gonna go. Mm-hmm. But he got it back together, which was great.
Happens to me all the time, and you guys, I was blown away by Aiden Bryant, who is the young aerialist. Like, that was insane, just spitting up in the air like that.
Yeah, that was crazy, and he said that he learned by just taking sheets and doing that in his house.
Mm-hmm. And when I get home, I know exactly what I'm gonna do, the curtains,
okay,
the
sheets. Let's see it. Wonderful.
That was another awesome act that I loved seeing. And coming up in the next few weeks of auditions, we're gonna have acts like Ray Singleton, mm-hmm. Nightbird, and Shuffalution. So
oh, yeah,
it's gonna be an awesome show.
Yes, guys, and every week we're gonna have a favorite performance, the worst performance, and a WTF. So let us know in the comments below what you think those three were this week.
Yes, and they're going to have us saying, what the bleep?
What the bleep?
But while we wait for next week's episode, let everybody know where they can find you.
At Billy Blanks Jr. on all platforms.
And you can catch me practicing my aerial skills at SamanthaX373 on Instagram. And while you're on YouTube, you should hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. Follow Talent Recap on all social medias and head over to talentrecap.com because we have all the scoop on America's Got Talent. And I think it's time for us to say, and that's our Talent Recap. Hey, what are you doing tonight? Well, I think you should hit that subscribe button down below and then we can talk.